Nothing into this world, and it is certain that we can carry nothing out. The Lord gave, and the Lord has taken away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. The eternal God is thy refuge, and the understanding are his everlasting arms. Whether we live unto the Lord. Whether we die unto the Lord. Whether we therefore die, we are of the Lord, for it is written, I am persuaded that neither death nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor heights, nor depths, not every creature, but whosoever believeth in God. Blessed is the God, the Father, and our Lord Jesus Christ, who is known both the living and the dead. I must have.
I must have.
That lay on the cross. can speak.
Come on, dead man, say.
Then my soul shall fear no evil. Let him lead. He will, he will.
Hallelujah, I will go.
I will go. Without trembling.
The name of our God is worthy to be praised. Yes, the Bible said, from the rising of the sun until the going down of the same, his name is worthy to be praised. Amen. Hallelujah. This evening, let me take this time out to welcome each and every one of you that made it possible to be here. On behalf of the family of Bishop Marcier, Patricia Morrison, Norman Brown Campbell, and the New Vigils family, I want to welcome you here tonight. I wish it was on a different occasion, maybe a birthday bashment or something like that. But you know, the writer said that death have a time to steal us away. And the thing about death is, it is an appointment that we cannot put off. We cannot call on that like we call on our doctor to say, I cannot make the appointment today, give me another date. Once it comes, there's nothing you and I can do about it. The writer said that. Jesus said, I will go to prepare a place for you. And when I go, I will come again to receive you unto myself. I can just imagine her mansion was ready. And because it was ready, then she had no other choice but to answer the call. Hallelujah. Amen. Let us stand and read. Tonight, when I look in the crowd that is here, we see, you know, Marcy was a person, Bishop Brown was a person that bring, you know, she brings people together. And just looking at the crowd tonight, you know, you can see it's a testament to tell that this is who Bishop Marcy Brown was. Amen. So tonight we're going to worship. It's a homegoing service. I know it's a little bit tight, but we're still going to worship anyway. We're going to stand, we're going to sing, we're going to clap, we're going to do all the lovely things that will make tonight a great night. We began on Friday. Bishop Orville White laid up a beautiful foundation on Friday. And Mother, what's your name for last night? Mother Diane. Mother Diane. Her name just slipped me for a minute. Mother Diane, she brought down the house last night. And today we come to put a final touch, to put the icing on the cake as we get ready to send our beloved sister home. Amen? So let's stand on your feet and we're going to sing to Canaan's land. No, Jerusalem, my happy home. Jerusalem.
Yeah.
our bishop, Mother Drucker, to come and open us in prayer. Why should I shrink from pain or woe?
Why should I shrink from
in your presence. We come, Lord God, as we gather at this ongoing service. We come, Lord God, and we know you are already here. Because of that, Lord God, tonight, oh God, you continue to be our refuge. And you continue, Lord God, to be our strength. Father, at this time, Lord, I put before you, Lord God, the bereaved family, the New Vision family, churches, God, and prelates, and whatever fear, whatever ecclesiastical function, God, they occupy. Father God, tonight, we come here, Lord, for no other reason but to show our respect and to say farewell to our sister departed. Father God, I pray, God, that this evening, Lord God, you will send ministering angels to direct the rest of this service. And that when we leave here, Lord God, we, oh Father God, can say we were blessed. Bless each and every one again. Remember the moderator. Remember, oh God, the servant, oh God, who tonight, Lord God, will break bread. Father God, I pray, God, for a fresh anointing tonight. Bless us, Lord, sanctify, God, and save us. Another time we say thanks to you.
Holy, holy, holy.
Oh,
are in a homegoing service. A child of God has gone home. And we are here to worship God for our life. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. At this time, we're going to have the Old Testament reading, which will be read by Apostle Patterson, which was Psalms 90, followed by the New Testament reading, will be read by Reverend Ray, John 14, 1-7. And they will come in that order.
Our Old Testament reading, speaking from Psalm 90, reading from verses 1 through 17. Lord, thou hast been our dwelling places in all generations. Before the mountains were brought forth, or even thou hast formed the earth and the world, even from everlasting to everlasting, thou art God. Thou turnest man to destruction, and sayest, return ye, children of men, for 1,000 years in thy sight, or but as yesterday when it is past, and as a watch in the night. Thou carriest them away as with the flood. They are as sheep. They are asleep, rather. In the morning they are like grass which groweth up. In the morning it flourisheth and groweth up. In the evening it is cut down and withereth. For we are consumed by thine anger, and by thy wrath are we troubled. Thou hast set our iniquities before thee, our secret sins in the light of thy countenance. For all our days are passed away in thy wrath. We spend our years as a tale that is told. The days of our years are 70 years, and if by reason of strength they be 80 years, yet is their strength labor and sorrow, for it is soon cut off, and we fly away. Who knoweth the power of thine anger? Even according to thy fear, so is thy wrath. So teach us to number our days, that we may apply our hearts unto wisdom. Return, O Lord, how long? And let it repent thee concerning thy servants. O satisfy us early with thy mercy, that we may rejoice and be glad all our days. Make us glad according to the days wherein thou hast afflicted us. And let the years wherein we have seen evil. Let thy work appear unto thy servants, and thy glory unto their children. Verse 17 and last. And let the beauty of the Lord our God be upon us, and establish thou the works of our hands upon us. Yea, the works of our hands establish thou it. Here ends a portion of the reading of God's holy word.
John chapter 14, verses 1-7. Let not your heart be troubled. He believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions, and if it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you, and if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there ye may be also. And whither I go, ye know, and the way ye know. Thomas said unto him, Lord, we know not whither thou goest, and how can we know the way? Jesus said unto him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. Verse 7 and ending. If ye had known me, he shall have known my Father's also. And from henceforth, he know him and have seen him. The word of the Lord.
You don't hear the voice from heaven say, come along.
You're not hear the voice from heaven say, come along.
Jesus, how I shall be satisfied.
Emmanuel, riding. the song I'm about to sing is one of Grandma's favorite songs. And anytime I was there, she'd always have me sing it. So if you know the song, please clap along and feel free to sway and wave your hands. Sometimes in our life, we all have pain. We all have sorrow. But if we are wise,
to lean on, no? Yes. Because I might have a problem that you can solve, no? So if I lean on you, then my problem is halfway solved, right? Somebody said, just call on me, brother and sister, when you need a hand. That means we have to be willing to what? Lend a hand. Amen, amen. At this time, we're going to the reading of the epistle. It will be read by Bishop Young. We'll be reading Revelation 21 from 1 to 7. Bishop Young.
Bless the name of Jesus, everybody. It's time for the reading. Revelation 21, reading verse 1. Whatever. A reading of here. And it reads thus. And I saw a new heaven and a new earth. For the first heaven and the first earth were passed away, and there was no more sea. And I, John, saw the holy city, New Jerusalem, coming down from God out of heaven, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a great voice out of heaven say, Behold, the tabernacle of God is with men, and he will dwell with them, and they shall be his people. And God himself shall be with them and be their God, and God shall wipe away all tears from their eyes. And there shall be no more death, neither sorrow, nor crying, neither shall there be any more pain, for the former things are passed away. And he that sat upon the throne said, Behold, I make all things new. And he said unto me, Write, for these words are true and faithful. And he said unto me, It is done. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. I will give unto him that is athirst of the fountain of the water of life free. Suddenly, he that overcometh shall inherit all things, and I will be his God, and he shall be my son. Here we are pushing God's word.
Glory be to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Ghost. As it was in the beginning, it's now and ever shall be.
By Elijah Norman, followed by Precious Moment by Alan Jackson. Rock of Ages, Rock of Ages, Rock of Ages, stay for me.
Maybe I'm not.
born. Hallelujah. Ding, 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 dong, 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 dong.
Hallelujah.
Great grandma.
Hallelujah.
I looked around the garden and found an empty place.
Amen.
She then looked down upon the rest and saw the entire thing. He put his arms around you and lifted you the rest. God brought you up to Jesus and he always takes the best. He saw the road was getting rough and the hills were hard to climb. So he closed your weary eyelids and wish the peace be found.
Amen, sir.
It broke our hearts to lose you, so you didn't go alone. For part of us went with you the day that I called you home. The day, a couple months before Grandma passed, she had a heart surgery. And I thought to myself how, you know, I really don't appreciate how much time, you know, the time that I spend with Grandma, being that I live right on top of her. And one day she had called me down because Pastor Hamilton had to step out and she just wanted some company. And she told me to put a movie on Netflix and I put a movie on. And we're watching a movie and she fell asleep before the middle part even got, you know, movie even started. And, you know, I looked at her and I just thought to myself how much I should do this for and spend more time with her. And just being around her made me feel better about myself. And, you know, I love Grandma, you know? And this past week, I've been spending a lot of time, like, away, you know, distant. And I read this quote and it said, God gives a lot of a lot of people that deserve the sun often have to deal with a lot of rainy days. And that's someone who I thought about Grandma. You know, Grandma deserved nothing but the world. And, you know, the universe got into everything in it. She deserved it. And, you know, I'm just happy that I can say that today she's somewhere getting a lot of sun. Probably close by a fan. With a big plate of food. No, I just want to say I love you, Grandma.
As other people say, as this young lady once said, I go by the name of Anna Jackson. And yesterday, I stated that Grandma, she was a grandmother, she was a friend, she was a mother, and she was a bishop. I want to start off by saying that when I got the news, it's like, it's almost like a nightmare that you're trying to wake up from. And as time goes past, it settles in your mind that it's actually reality. And that's the hardest part. Yesterday, I stated that Grandma, with my cousins, we came to the conclusion that Grandma, she's full of life. You see her, she lit your day up, and she made your day. And today I want to touch on her strength, how strong Grandma was. Grandma, she battled heart surgeries, asthma, diabetes, and she always find a way to keep a smile on her face and welcome people in. Grandma was really strong. Grandma was really strong even when I was younger and I used to get in a lot of trouble. And my mother used to tear me up. I told mother, I love you. She said, I love you too, but you gotta get it. So I looked at her, I said, she don't know this one. I ran downstairs, ran inside grandma's room. Grandma locked me in her door. And she said, ah, why are you gonna get my grandson? And my mother's like, he gotta get it. And I was laughing at her. She couldn't get me. See, sucks to be you. But who's gonna see me from that now? On Friday, the first service, I was crying a lot, a lot, a lot. And I told my father that she didn't even get to see me graduate high school. She was so close. And my father waited, and he said, Aaron, that's not true. She's gonna see you graduate high school from the best view, heaven. So, as gathered here with all these people today, what does my grandmother's death symbolize to you? For me, my grandmother's death symbolized strength, brightness, the reason I have a smile on my face. Cause that, I can say that's my grandmother. Amen. But some of you are saying goodbye to grandmother. Grandma's still with me. On that note, I love you all. Have a best day.
Good evening, everyone, once again. This evening, this song that I'm about to sing, like the first speaker said, this homegoing service is no longer about Bishop, but it is about those that's left behind. Hopefully, we will be ready to be caught up to meet him. I hear the sound of a mighty rushing wind, and it's closer now than it's ever been. I can almost hear the trumpet as Gabriel sounds the call. The midnight cry, we'll be going home. When Jesus steps out on the ground to call his children, that remains.
walk around me in these dark times. Yeah, I see prophecies fulfilling, oh, everywhere.
Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. Hallelujah.
The first person that I'm going to call to give reflection is going to be no other person than Bishop Mark Adolphus.
Jesus keeps me near the cross. Near the precious fountain.
Reverend Father, His Grace, His Eminence, Dr. Alan Jones, to the bereaved family, to the church family, to the conclaves of bishops that are so very present on and off the form, the Christ in me exalt and greet the Christ that is in you tonight. Amen. I'm going to say that again. But some of you did not hear. The Christ in me greets and exalts the Christ in you. Yes. Tonight we are saddened, but we are happy. I oftentimes says that death is a friend to the sufferer. All the medication that our sister and all the sickness that she has gone through, if medication could have helped her, we would not be here tonight. Medication could not take her out of her suffering and out of her pain. But it takes a friend that we call death to come and to release her from her sickness. That is a bridge that takes us over into that new Jerusalem that we are talking about. And I'm about to take my seat because I don't want my rope tail to be pulled tonight. But I want to touch on John chapter 21 just for a few minutes, a few seconds. And something there provoked my spirit. John said, I heard a voice that comes out of heaven. Now this was not a messenger that was talking. This was not an angel that was talking. This was not a prophet or a prophetess that was talking. But John said, I heard a voice out of heaven, and it sounds like the voice of the Almighty God. And the Bible says that God Himself shall be with Marcia Brown, and God has wiped away her tears. And there will be no more death, and there will be no more pain, for I saw a new Jerusalem coming down out of the throne of God as a bride adorned to meet the her husband Cornel, but she's going also to meet her spiritual husband. May vision be thou strong, be thou courageous. It is sad that you have lost two leaders, two powerful leaders in a short space of time. I sat there and I look upon you and I said, you ought to make to feel special, because your church has made history. It's the first I've seen a church send off two powerful leaders in a short space of time to heaven. You should be rejoicing. Amen. God bless you.
Dr. Brown.
I just want to bless the Lord this evening. Amen. And I'm looking at Proverbs 31, 20 and 21. She stretched out her hands to the poor. She stretched out her hands to the needy. She is not afraid of sorrows, for her household are gathered with scarlet. Praise God this evening. I just want to extend a wonderful greeting to the wonderful Rasta Associate, wonderful Bishop, most wonderful Atari. You're looking good. Praise God. I am here this evening and I'm very sad. I'm with mixed feelings. I was very close with Dr. Marcier. We had a good relationship from her late husband, Pastor Brown. And I did not get to participate in the past event, so I just want to take this moment to encourage the bereaved families, the church families, and children and grandchildren. And I'm very sure that she had made it in. She's in a better place. She's not dead. If she were dead, she would not be looking like that. So don't be worried. Don't worry about it. She just gone over there. I just got verse of this song because of the load of speaker. I want to be humble and honored.
Amen.
Amen. Somebody somewhere was praying that night when Jesus came in and I saw the light. It must have been Mama. I heard her before. When the prayer start to master and the tears start to flow. Thank you, Mama, for praying for me. If you were not praying, where would I be? They call you old fashioned, but you love the Lord. As the fire starts to master and the tears start to flow. She held to the altar and would not give in, till she knew all her children had been born again. They call her old fashioned, but she loved the Lord. Well, when the prayer start to master and the tears start to flow. Thank you, Mama, for praying for me. If you were not praying, where would I be? Well, they call you old fashioned, but you love the Lord. As the prayer starts to master and the tears start to flow. She's gone up there. God bless you.
Bishop,
praise the Lord.
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 Let me give honor to God. Let me greet everyone, all my father's children, in the mighty name of Jesus. I sat there and I'm thinking of everything that Bishop Brown and I have been through. Ever since I met her, she said to me, as of today, you are my son. And anywhere you're going, near or far, once you're driving, let me know because I'll be right here. And every time I'm journeying to Maryland or wherever, it's Bishop Brown and Bishop Stewart. And I remember many times how she and I would talk. I don't think anyone would have thought that way with her. But sometimes I was a bishop, I'll call and I'll say, Bishop, may I come on here something? And she said, hallelujah, Jesus, glory to God. And one day she called me and she said to me, December she called when I was traveling on assignment. And she said to me, it's been 3 weeks I haven't seen you. What am I do? So Bishop, you're not doing nothing. She said, let me tell you something. My target in the church, I'm a target everywhere I go. You, now walk in my life, I walk out of it. Until death do us part. So Bishop, I'm not going away. I said, let me tell you something, Bishop Brown. You coming like Louis Bennett. When you tell stories, you emphasize so much, you feel like I was there. So why are you never going to drama? You should be an actress. And she was like, glory to God, hallelujah. And then she was like, Bishop never cooks through peel. Make sure enough dumping and pick till the night and bring mine come. Hallelujah, glory to God, thank you, Jesus. And if you see the end, I'm going to reach under yet. Shadow call. Where my stew piece there? I said, may I come. I remember once I was in my office. And Bishop Brown, her spirit, walked into my office. And just as she walked there, I turned around and I saw her and I said, Bishop Brown, what are you doing here? And so I took the phone up and I called Pastor Hamilton. What happened to Bishop Brown? So she started telling me what happened. This trip, I was in my office again. And just as I felt her presence, when I was about to pick the phone up to call Pastor Hamilton, she called me and said, Bishop Brown is in the hospital. And when I heard, you know what happened, I went to look for her and I hold her hand, she squeezed my hand, she bring it up to her bosom and I said, I'm right here and I'm not going anywhere. She looked and she squeezed. And let me tell you, when I heard that day when she passed, Sunday morning, I was heading to the Bronx with Bishop Young. And she came in, my spirit so strong, I said, Bishop Young, to be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. And I keep saying that, I said, Bishop Brown is so strong in my spirit that I don't know, but after service, I'm going to go down there and I'm going to spend the rest of the Sunday evening with her. And he said he's going to come. And just as I let them off at the church, I went and I parked. And I sat in the car for so long, and all I was saying, Lord, to be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. And then I got the phone call that she was gone. She's always saying to me, don't walk out of my life. But that Sunday, she walked out of my life. But I thank God for her journey, and I thank God for everything. And tonight, I was trying to, you know, think of a song that when we journey, she was always singing to me, I'm a pilgrim and a stranger. And she was singing like my death with everybody.
You're right.
But rough and thorny is in her way. But I know that
The songwriter said, I came to Jesus as I was. So I know that when she was weary and when she was worn and sad, she found in him a resting place. And because of that assurance, I know that the trumpet will sound and she will rise again. So I will meet her on the other side of Jordan.
Before we go any further, Bishop Marcia Brown's sister, Sister Carr, will be leaving soon, so we're going to have her give her a church right now.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord, church.
Praise the Lord.
It's one thing I can tell you about her. She loved to praise. And when she said, praise the Lord, she loved to hear we echo praise of God because he's worthy to be praised.
Amen.
My sister promised me, so she was going to go leave me. And I told her no. The conversation usually come like this. You know, when Diane leave me, because if you Diane leave me, then we have to bury the two of us together. But you're gone. And God know the reason why.
Amen.
I was sick, she was sick. I have machine in my heart. I said, we have to walk with peace of it. She had a stent put in. But you know something? Sometimes when our burden getting more than us, God alleviates somebody's pain. The Saturday before she died, my daughter went to see her and she put the phone at her ears. And I was talking to her and I asked her a question. I said, are you all right? And she said, yes. That's the last word I hear from my sister. Yes. They said she squeezed my daughter's hand. She opened their eyes and she was looking for the boys. My sister and I was very close. We were sometimes like I. But the love was always there. Whenever there was a problem and she get any kind of, when she reached to me, anywhere I'm at, she found me. Anywhere I'm at work, she find me. If I'm at home, she find me. I go on vacation and the problem too much for her and she find me and call me. I won't have that anymore. But I have the assurance from God that it's only for God. Saints, love one another. Not by lips, but love them the way God so loved each other. Because in the midst of life, we are in there. Take care of each other. You don't have to have $1 million to be kind. Stop being mean to each other. Stop saying things that you know don't go like that. Because there's a man watching over us. My sister went through a lot. She went through a lot more than most people would know. But you know something, through it all, she learned to trust God. And because of that, I can say she got the arrest. She earned the arrest. It might look like it to some, but it's a long time she's coming. God sees she had done her work that she was meant to do.
And that is why he called her. God bless you. God bless you.
Bishop Marcy Brown's friend, come on, Bishop. Reverend Duncan, shall we praise the Lord?
Hallelujah.
Shall we praise the Lord?
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah!
Tonight I am here. I'm not going to say I'm sad. It's a home that we all should be preparing for.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So if we live the right life, then we don't have to be sad, because you know that one day, one sweet day, we all shall meet in that beautiful land. The choir is singing the last song. And I know it's time to go. But something is happening right here, right now, and I can't get off my knees. I want to leave you at the altar for a while. If you know the chorus, help me sing it. Leave you. I want to leave.
waiting, Lord, for a blessing.
Bishops, to the family of Bishop Marcia Brown, and to New Vision. Your mother, your grandmother, your pastor, your friend has gone from labor to reward. What a mighty woman she was, a faithful servant of the Lord. And so I just leave you with the words of the Apostle Paul, 1 Thessalonians 4, beginning 13. But I would not have you to be ignorant, brethren, concerning them which are asleep, that ye sorrow not, even as others which have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even them which also sleep in Jesus will God bring with him. I remind you what you already know, that this is not the end. The Lord bless you.
Grace and peace be unto you from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. Tonight we come to celebrate a woman of God who I had the privilege of meeting first at the Church of the Holy Redeemer. One of the things that made me make my way here tonight more than anything else is the smile that she portrayed. My first encounter with her was through a smile. It would do us well if we were to really celebrate her life, to emulate and duplicate what she presented. There are some of us that when we meet, it is not always a smile on your face. I would question how happy you really are, especially when we claim our Christianity. But Bishop Brown represented that smile, and I want to challenge us to consider it for our days ahead. Let me say these words to you concerning humanity. Night is a period. It is a period, if you will, of darkness in 24 hours. May I suggest to you that although night is a period of darkness in 24 hours, it is from the sunset to the sunrise.
Yes.
It's night for Bishop Brown's life because sunset has taken place.
Yeah.
It's night because Bishop Brown has gone to sleep. She's gone to sleep in Christ. The inevitable has presented itself. It's called death. Death cannot be escaped by any of us. However, let me suggest to you that while it is night, remember I indicated it is only for a period of time. In the Christian faith, we understand the theology of resurrection, that we will get up. And thus I suggest to us tonight that we understand that though her body lies in this casket, and though she sleeps in Christ, there is a getting up moment that will take place. That's an understanding that weeping may endure for a night, a period of darkness in the 24 hours. But joy will come in the morning. And it's indicating that night does not last forever. Night is only for a short time. But morning always breaks. I want to challenge the Brown family. Morning time will come. Not M-O-U-R-N-I-N-G, but M-O-R-N-I-N-G. When the sun shall rise, the trumpet will sound, and the dead in Christ, Bishop Brown, will rise again. Let's remember that with all that we do. Let's remember we have hopes to see her again, and morning time is soon to come. Amen.
Unknown waves before
glad, for great shall be our reward in heaven. We bless the Lord.
Amen.
I sat alone in life memory. It's a and to Spirit of God first, to all the bishops, all the prophets, all the every that's sitting on the behind me. Amen. We are here to send home our sister in celebration. We can't just sit down and think an angel will walk in and wipe away your tears. We have to rejoice. We have to be happy that our sister is going home. Amen. We have to be happy for our sister. She is not no more long, as some of the bishops speak a while ago, she's no more longer in pain. She's no more longer in sorrow. So we must be happy for her. Amen.
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 from the front. Every blessing to my heart will sing, I pray. All the way, my Savior leads me.
Let me hear you praise the name of the Lord. Come on, somebody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Let me greet the bishops on the phone, archbishops, the pastor, Pastor Copeland. You're looking prettier and prettier every time you
see. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. Let me greet you all this evening in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. I am here and I'm not feeling sad, neither am I worried. The first time I met Bishop Marcia Brown, it's when I preached at Bishop Jones Church, the first time at Bishop Mother Drickett's appreciation service. And just after I preached there, we got downstairs and she grabbed me aside and said, I need to talk to you. And believe me, she had that infectious love. And from then it just take over. Bishop Marcia Brown know that I do not like to leave my church on the first Sunday. And one first Sunday she called me and said, Bishop Austin, I am having something and I need you today. And believe me, she didn't get off the phone until I said yes. And today she has me standing over her on the first Sunday saying something nice about her. We have a lot of people, so let me brief say. Charles Wesley put it in a different way. And he is the younger brother of John Wesley. And this is how he put it. Oh, love divine. How sweet thou art. When shall I find my willing heart all taken up by thee? He go a little further by saying, I die to prove the greatness of redeeming love. Our sister Marcia, Bishop Brown, is demonstrating to us tonight one thing, the full meaning of redeeming love. In closing, the Grace Trillers out of Jamaica,
come on now,
put it in another way.
Yes.
And I want you to join with me, yes, by saying this.
Yes.
Time will come for the last goodbye. There will be a smile. Oh, no.
Bishop Hall, will you come in? Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, sisters and brothers. I greet you in the mighty name of Jesus and all God's cabinet. Holy greetings. You know, as David had said, when his son died that he got with Bathsheba, David wouldn't eat nothing at all. He refused to eat and praying that that God will restore his son. But the time has come when it's not what David wants. And God took that son away from him. And David turned to his servants and said, bring me water to wash my hands and food to eat. And the servant says, oh master, you are going to eat at this time when the boy is dead. And David said, there is nothing else can I do. While he was alive, I was praying that God would heal him. And he did not. Now he's dead. What else can I do? Bring me food to eat. So tonight, eat food. Because there is nothing we can do for Bishop Brown. And I just want to say one thing. A friend of mine always tell me, believe half of what you see and none of what you hear. Because I met Bishop Brown at her church while Overseer Wallace had his program there. But come in contact with a woman of God and what John Public says negative things about her, you wouldn't want to meet with her. But as Paul says, try the spirit for yourself.
Hallelujah.
And when I met this woman, and I tried the spirit, misery love company. It was nothing at all that John Public was saying about the woman of God. I know the husband, Bishop Brown, and he too was a principal man. But he has gone before. But I tell you, believe half of what you see and nothing what you hear. God bless you.
Praise the Lord, praise God. This evening, the song that we are going to be doing is a song that for years I've been asking Pastor Hamilton if she knows the song. And for another week, could not get the song. And 2 days before our bishop passed, we got the song. Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. Always asking for the song. Lord, I'm working for my crown. Though they try to knock me down, yes, they owe one and all. They just can't wait to see me fall. But your will, Lord, must counting on you.
Unto us, the most honorable Father on the throne, the care of God and the Holy Ghost.
We call him by his name. Please be seated. I will rather be brief, giving honor to the Holy Spirit of Almighty God, who is the head of every man. And to my pulpit associates, and we have to recognize Emmanuel, yes, and thanking God for Pastor Dutchmore, yes, for allowing us,
yes, sir,
to use this edifice.
Amen. Thank you, Lord.
This is not a night of a sermon. It's a night of reflection, and it's also an evening of thought. Marcia, or Bishop Brown's sister, have spoken the word. Of course, I'm not the presiding bishop of New Vision. And I shan't say how long I've known Bishop Brown. But I speak not of the dead, but I make a pertinent inquiry. What kind of a seed have we planted? And to my fellow bishops, amen, what kind of seed are we sowing?
Amen.
Paul, we know that he was what he is.
Yes.
But God transformed his life when he was on his way to Damascus. And he made a pertinent inquiry to the Corinthians, because the Corinthians were troublesome set of people, believing various gods. But Paul stated, though I speak with the tongues of men and of angel, and of that love, that charity is love.
Amen.
And I have sat in the seat of humility, and I've heard the reflection of stew peas and rice and of pigtail and etc. etc. So we see that Bishop Brown was not only talking, she was doing. For a lot of us talk about love, but we don't know how to show it. What kind of a seed? Bishops are not totalitarianists, you know. And of course, we have synod and conferences. The bishop only suggests.
Right.
So anything you want to do, you do. But don't blame the bishop. Because the bishop cannot save you if you do not save yourself. For your parents have taught you, show me your company and I'll tell you who you are. What kind of a seed? Paul said, though I speak with the tongues of men and no shoulder. Not as like to become emphatic at funeral and say how good people are. But did you tell them when they were alive? An organized church and articles of religion and canon laws. And today we find people do what they want to do. But it's about time we put a stoppage to it. Let me see what kind of a seed you are sowing. Discord?
Yes.
Jesus sat minding his own business. And a lawyer came to bother him. Be careful what you say and to whom you say it to. For your words will come back and harm you. Beware of social media. For what you say will harm you. The query, what kind of a seed you're sowing. The morticians are waiting to take the body out. So I'm going to be rather brief. And make sure that you're able to take yourself out after I'm finished. Because conscience is a heck of a thing. For we see men's face, but we don't see their hearts. For the hearts of men are desperately wicked. As the bishop stated, don't believe everything you hear. Because some say bad things about Marcy Brown. And today we're saying how lovely she is. Mm-hmm. And when I don't preach, you're going to give me hell, but me not care. Because my song is indicted in a good letter. Come on, church, what kind of a seed? Yes, sir.
Come on, Bishop.
The lawyer sat and justification is so filled in the church. Justifying himself, Master.
Yeah.
What should I do to inherit eternal life?
Come on.
And Jesus read all that. We know that already. Everything Jesus said, I know that already. But Jesus said, listen to me. I want to find out what have you sown. But you have answered correctly. But I want to find out whether or not you are living a life. Because many of us talk a life, but we ain't living a life. What are you sowing? Discord? Rejection? Criticism? Antagonization? And try to destroy the church of God. You can never win. You can never destroy a church for his mercy. Is everlasting. Ask yourself the question, what sort or kind of a seed are you sowing? My church, your church, others, bishops, churches, and even your own church. Because no man destroyed the church from the outside. The church is destroyed from the inside. My friends that are theologically inclined and are in the sense of scholarly presentation, Jesus said, one of you shall betray me. It was not the Pharisees and the scribes, or the Pharisees on the outside, it was Judas Iscariot. What a lie! What a lie! Shakespeare, bubble, bubble, toil and trouble. That's from Macbeth. But Shakespeare went on to say, he that steal my bread, steal trash. Are you deception in the church?
Yes.
Yes.
And what have we stole from Bishop Brown? We brought nothing to this world. And we certainly can take that. The Lord giveth and the Lord asketh. What are you sowing? Now I'm going to show you what you're sowing. Jesus said, a certain man, went down from Jerusalem to Jericho and fell among thieves who stripped him, beat him, and leaving him out there. But behold it, not your heart be troubled. Fell among thieves who beat him. Tongue lashing is better than a beating. No, no. A beating is better than tongue lashing. But the word of God tells me, don't worry about long tongue people. Because the tongue cannot be tamed. But if you're a child of God, why should you worry when you can say, in thee, in thee, in thee, O Lord, have I put my trust. Christian Brown and Marcia wasn't a weakling. And no child of God can be a weakling. For he told you in Ephesians, stop saying this verse and not believe it. You wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principality and power and spiritual wickedness in our flesh. So it's a constant war. It's a battle, not only between the devil, but with those that call you friends. I like the back of these kisses. Because the Lord said to Judas, after he kissed him, we call Jesus friend. What are you sowing? Do I rest in peace? Are you going to find somebody else to chat? How to put it back? How to know about her business? Our doings. But we, the servant of God, will be effective and efficient and be fervent, and it's about time we close the lion's mouth. Falling a
Come on.
He's doing it.
Yeah.
Following me, stripping him.
Yes, right.
Leaving him out there. And what bothered me? The priests like me pass by and look upon him. And the deacon passed by and look upon him. For when we are clad in our clerical apparel, and when we take the high post in the synagogue, we think that we're worthy more than the man on the street. But how can you no sins, we see all and the truth is nothing.
Amen.
Lord, I say I'm here for you tonight.
Yes.
We caught her in adultery, and according to the law of Moses, she would and ought to be stoned. And Jesus said, and Jesus said, and Jesus said, let him, let him, we all sing. I am sending you with your lips of criticism, because you think you win, but you ain't winning. For the fight has just begun, for the word of God becoming effective. But a known entity, a synodite,
strong word,
by the name of a Samaritan guy. People ever look down at you? Whether or not you see
him,
people will look at you and label you because they want to be a friend of Satan. Was not guilty, but he wants to be a friend of Caesar. Stop being friends of Caesar and friend of the truth and righteousness. Let me bring this whole matter to conclusion, because the body is about to be taken away. I know it opened my notes, because I'm here to ask, we the living, a pertinent question. What seed are we sowing? Of course it's pertinent, by the fruits we shall know them. And it tells you in the Psalms what? Blessed is man, for you shall be like that. I want to thank God that you're looking prosperous. But in your prosperity, look up onto the hills from whence come your help. The help came in the form of a Samaritan. Look and find yourself in that category. When you love to help people, you take your kindness. But you spit in the sky. Take care of the people who you meet going up. For they're going to be the same one you can remember and not preaching. And only reflecting. For the goodness and the love of that man. He didn't care whether or not he was white or black. For the Jews have no part with the Samaritans. And we see here, you're a Trinidad, you're a Jamaican, you're a Guyanese, and they draw cards. But when you're a child of God, no man can draw a card. And he came over and he showed love, as Marcia's sister said. When and where and why do we stop loving each other?
I think it's Bishop Hopkins or Hawkins that stated that Charles Wesley, the founder of the Methodist Church, which has changed its name, O Love Divine. Oh, sweet the Lord. This woman was a woman of love. And we can testify. We can lift our hands and hearts and eyes to heaven. But Master Paul, Bishop, was a woman of integrity. Because Paul said, I don't want to hear nothing. I know that they're heresy and division, but I don't want to hear it too. But Jesus and Him crucified.
Amen.
Let this be a lesson.
Yes.
Let this be a portal of light.
Yes.
Where we ought to see each other.
Yes.
When the mist is rolled away.
Yes.
New Vision, please stand. I will just leave with you love. I will just leave with you love. And the word from Paul. Be strong in the Lord and the power of His might. For you wrestle not against flesh and blood, but principalities and powers. Be strong in the Lord and make sure the church go from strength to strength. God bless you in Jesus' name.
Ah!
The service is not over. The body is just leaving, so please take your seat. The service is not over. The body is just leaving. Please take your seat and please let us continue with the program. Amen?
Amen.
We're almost finished. We're almost to that point, but at this time there's a lot of talking, and I'm asking you please to take your seat. Sweet Lord, sweet chariot, come in for to carry me home. Sweet child. coming down. Bishop Bourne is all the way from Canada. He came all the way. So come on, everybody, the church. Come on, Bishop.
Yes, sir.
Somebody lift up the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Come on, lift up the name of the Lord. Lift up the name of Jesus. Come on, lift up the name of Jesus. The dead is already dead. Hallelujah. For the church is still alive. Somebody give God some praise in here. Come on, lift up the name of the Lord. Give honor to Jesus, my Redeemer. Praise God to New Vision. Bless God to the ministers on the platform. Praise God. Father Jones, everyone in this house tonight, I extend greetings to you all in the name of Jesus. Praise God. I stopped by here tonight to extend, praise God, condolences to the family. Praise God, of our sister and to the church that she pastored. Oh, praise God, and to the revival community here in New York. Somebody praise the name of the Lord. Amen. Truly we understand that we have lost, amen, an icon from amongst us. Praise God. The preacher have just said it, and it is difficult. Oh, praise God, when a sentence is complete or a paragraph is complete to start a new one. Oh, somebody praise God. Amen. The church is still alive. But can I say that again? The church is still alive. And amen. Why the church is still alive? Because Jesus is still with us. Oh, praise the name of the Lord. And tonight, praise God, as the preacher said, it was only a reflection. Oh, praise God. And when you reflect, amen, on Marcia Brown, or rather Bishop Marcia Brown, praise God, amidst everything that has been said, you can't help but admire her. Oh, praise the name of the Lord. Wherever she would show up, oh, praise God, there would be an aura that many people didn't carry. Oh, praise the name of the Lord. Amen. Whether it was one word that she said, you had to smile. Oh, praise the name of the Lord, or take a second look, because she carried something special about her. Is the church of God still here? Oh, praise the name of Jesus. It takes much for me to be here tonight. Oh, praise God. And I look back at the years that I've been acquainted with this woman. Oh, bless the name of the Lord. And I said to myself that I had to be here even to hear the last, or to see the last of her going out. Is the church still here?
Yes.
But as I'm saying, amen, New Vision, praise God. You were told earlier to be strong in the Lord. Amen. The bishop is gone home. She has finished her journey.
Yes, sir.
Oh, praise the name of the Lord. But amen, your journey continues. Is the church still here?
Yes.
Your journey still continues. And praise God, if you love her as you are exhibiting tonight, you will ensure that the church stays alive. Oh my God, oh my God, oh my God. If we as ministers of the gospel in Zion, amen, appreciated and loved her the way we are saying that we do, amen, we will ensure that we help to keep the church alive. Amen.
Amen.
Oh, praise God. When I understood about her death, I just could not believe it. Because there's some folks that you really want to see live forever. Meanwhile, there's some amongst us that you would wish they would die 100 years ago. You see, I don't live in New York City, so I can't say that because I don't earn tomorrow morning. There are some folks that you would wish that they weren't born. They're still living, you know. But the good is God. But hear what the song says, Lord, it belongs not to my head. Oh,
Oh, Jesus, it is surely an appointment that every man wants to die. The Bible declares, but after death comes the judgment. You don't need a theological degrees to understand this. Oh, praise the name of the Lord. All you need to do is to believe God's word. Amen. Because it came from the dust. Is the church still up in here? Well, no matter how much you bleach out your skin. And I know Marcy a long time. Oh, bless the Lord. Put your little brother like that. I was not sure she bleach like that. I said she looked black all the time. One thing I know, she should eat well. Amen. Because it showed. But whether you use the whitening, are the cheap cream, are the expensive one, you're going back to the dust from where you came. Church of God, it's preparation time. And that's all I want to say to somebody tonight. Likewise to myself, it's preparation time. And as we reflect on the life of the woman of God that has gone home to rest, let us reflect on our own lives and ask ourselves the question, as the preacher said, what seed are you sowing? To the church of God that remains, praise God, be strong. Amen. Take courage. Keep on leaning upon the Lord. I want to believe that, though you love your pastor, but praise God, you must have recognized that she was not the one who gave you life, nor afforded you salvation. It came only through Jesus Christ. And so I want you to continue to lean upon him, because in him there is life. In him there is hope. You will not find another Marcia Brown. Don't look for another one like her. She was unique. She was one of a kind. Amen. Cut from a very rare breed. So don't look to find anybody else like her. And they say, oh, I'm a summer pastor, or some other so bishop used to do it. She's gone on to rest. Follow the path. Follow the path. I hear where God is leading you. God bless you. Thank you. In Jesus' name.
Hallelujah.
Shall we worship the Lord? Come on, somebody shout hallelujah. Shout hallelujah. Across the hot burning desert, I'm struggling at the right.
you. But somewhere up ahead there is cool, clear water. And the deed is one word that I won't use. Give it over tonight to the Spirit of God, and I greet you all in the mighty name of Jesus. You see, I remember the last conversation I had with Bishop Brown. Oh, somebody worship God. Somebody worship God. And I want to say to the Church of God tonight that I will cherish those memories until we meet again. God bless you in Jesus' name.
Oh, come on and bless the Lord Jesus.
Come on and praise the name of Jesus. Come on and worship God. Come on and praise Him. Praise the Lord. 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 Praise the Lord.
Christ, who is the head and keeper of my life. Bless God. Then all protocol observed in Jesus' name. Bless God. You know, I met Bishop Brown a long time ago, over 10 years. And she has blessed my heart. She might not say much, but she shows love. And even though she didn't know me from a long time ago, when I came and I saw her, she received me and she called me her son. Yeah. Amen. Bless the name of Jesus. And so when we are living our lives, we want to have what is called a legacy. Yeah. Oh, bless the name of Jesus. Yeah. And when you have died, your legacy still lives on. Yeah. Come on and bless the name of Jesus. And so as when Moses had died, God commanded Joshua that only that he should be of good courage. And so I want to implore you, visionize, to continue to stay on the firing line. And with God as your shepherd, he will lead you the right way. God bless you.
My home is in heaven, waiting for me. And when I reach there, how happy I'll be. My home is in heaven, no rent to pay. My Jesus paid it all for me.
Marcia Brown, but let me say this, she left a church behind, she left a family behind. So since you didn't get a chance to say something here, I encourage you to go to the church and minister to the children, encourage the spirit because they are going to need it. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. So everyone to stand, we're going to have our Pastor Butler is going to come to the vote of thanks. And Bishop Father Jones is going to do the benediction.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Just wanted to greet the rostrum to you, what the call has been called. And I want to thank you for, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
You can be seated for a second. Because I get to sit and listen to all the wonderful, outpouring, joyful things that I can hear about my mother. And you see, as she going on, I want to thank God for the heavenly light, the character that He formed in her, and the moment that we all got to spend with her. You see, sometimes people don't like what you talk. You say you have ups and you have downs. But through it all, we had love. And you see, no matter how rough it got, you always had a smile at the end of the day.
Amen.
A smile and a hug.
Yes.
And that hug making every issue, everything. Yes. So I want to thank you for 3 days of celebration because you could have been somewhere else. But you took your time out to spend with my family, my church family. And I just want to tell you thank you from the bottom of my heart. Father Jones, praise the Lord.
Just one little verse, please stand. Bless me the tide that die. Oh, bless me the tide that die. Come to me. Can't see it.
Bless me, God's heart,
all hearts in Christian life.
Oh,
Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord lift up the light of his countenance and be gracious unto you and give you peace. And now unto him that is able to keep you from falling and present you faultless before the throne of God with exceeding great joy. The one and only true God, to him all honor, dominion and power. And may the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit rest, remain, and abide with us all now and forevermore. Remember, tomorrow is the burial service. Amen.